Awful Panther returns. Ladies and gents, welcome back to yet another news episode where today I am going to take my first a little bit deeper look at Aufklärungs Panther 5. Did I succeed? Was it close enough? Or let's hear how professionals do it.
Aufklärungspanzer V. Aufklärungspanzer V.
I believe I was close enough, but guys, in today's episode I am going to take my first deeper look at the new Tier 8 premium light tank, upcoming premium light tank, Aufklärungspanzer V, but the gameplay action you see on the background is actually from the patch 9.6, so this battle over here is super old, but it was one of the best battles overall. With, here we go again, with Aufklärungspanzer Panther, because this is how it was named when it was in the tier 7 position, before they removed it. And at the end of the episode I am going to show you yet another map that is going to be reworked into the HD quality, and this time you are going to see fjords. And let me tell you guys, I was super surprised how this new fjords or new HD quality fjords looks like. It looks pretty damn hot, but without further ado, let's jump right into the action and let's start talking about this Aufklärungspanzer V, the Tier 8 premium light tank from Germany. Here are a couple of pictures how its new HD model is going to look like, and I really like the front of the vehicle. It looks like some kind of plow. But if you guys remember, the old Awful Panther in the tier 7 position was super awesome rammer as well. You were able to one shot or one ram AMX 1375 to death from full HP, going downhill or at full speed. Yes, you were able to do it in this vehicle. So this is kind of a mini E50M. It is super big for a light tank. It has actually pretty decent armor as well for a light tank in the tier 8 position. But now I believe let's not waste any more time and let's take a look at first specs. Or actually, this is not the first version of this vehicle on the Supertest server. These are tuned statistics. Penetration was nerfed, the TPM was nerfed a little bit. So this vehicle was spotted on the Supertest server much earlier. But now they decided to tune it, and this is actually official information from Wargaming itself. And most likely this is going to be how this tank enters into the server or into the game, at least. I believe so. But keep in mind, all those stats are subject to change, as you can see from this picture as well. So, specs. Tier 8 vehicle with 1100 hit points. Not bad for a Tier 8 light tank. Hull armor 85, 50 and 40. 85 in the front with that kind of slope is not bad, guys. It really is not bad for a light tank. As I said before, although turret doesn't have any armor whatsoever, but it is not the biggest turret at the same time, just compare this turret to the hull. It is fairly big vehicle, yes, so armor, I don't know how effective this is going to be, maybe versus tier 6 vehicles, tier 7 vehicles, you are able to bounce something, but versus tier 9s, tier 10s, do not even dream about bouncing something. Or if you did, you can consider yourself being extremely lucky. So turret armor 50, 30 and 30. No armor whatsoever. Moving on, turret traverse speed, not bad, 48 degrees per second. Hull traverse speed, 44. This tank is going to have 900 horsepower engine. 900 horsepower engine on a light tank, not bad, but power to weight ratio is only 21.5 horsepower per ton, because it is quite heavy light tank. As I said, mini E50M. View range is really good. Stock view range 410 meters, guys. You can easily get it over 450 meters without any problems whatsoever. I believe you do not even need to go to the optics. If you go for ventilation, food and brothers in arms under crew members, for example, and crew skills as well, I believe you are able to get over 450 meters easily without using any view range boosting equipment units. But if you would like to devalue some camo value, then of course you should use go to the optics at least. Top speed 65, not bad. Reverse speed is actually pretty good as well, 25, moving backwards. Gun elevation angles minus 10 degrees of gun depression. Even though from the picture I can see that this turret is super low, and I'm not 100% sure that you're able to achieve minus 10 degrees of gun depression in the front. Just look at this picture. How can you cut minus 10 degrees frontally? I don't know, maybe you can, but I believe it maybe is on the side or something like that. Just be ready for it. Gun elevation angle plus 20 degrees, not bad. Penetration is 204. It was actually nerfed down from 221, so minus 17 penetration from the previous version. But this ammunition type, I believe, is APCR with 1260 meters per second shell velocity, not bad. Damage was buffed from 165 to 180, but it is still that good old awful banter with low alpha damage gun. But 204 for a tier rate premium light tank, I believe I can work with that. But moving on, stock accuracy 0.33, aiming time 1.5 seconds and reload time 5.2 seconds. So TPM is not going to be out from this world. What is that TPM actually? Quickly let me see. TPM was slightly nerfed from the previous version, from 2100 to 2077 TPM. And accuracy was also nerfed. The old accuracy was 0.28 or 29 rounded up. Okay, so this is, or these are first specs about the upcoming Tier 8 Premium Light Tank. And if I am going to compare it to some other Tier 8 light tanks, to HWK-12, M4190GF, LTTP and M41 Bulldog, then I can see that this tank has by far the best penetration. Second place goes to the GF with 182, so almost actually over 20 extra penetration over all those guys that I just mentioned. Alpha damage is not the best, but not the worst either. Not as good as an HWK-12 or on 90GF that gets 240, but exactly the same as an LTTP, for example. And my biggest concern about this vehicle is it is going to be yet another Tier 8 German premium light tank. We already have that special M4190GF, aka Black Bulldog, with no auto-loading system. What else interesting? Shell velocity seems to be the best with APCR ammunition, stock APCR ammunition. 1.5 second aiming time is by far the best. The second place goes to the Black Bulldog with 1.73 seconds. And speed, mobility, not the best. Once again, first place goes to the Black Bulldog with 72.4 kph, not bad. 65 was on Aufklärungspanzer 5, as we remember, but reverse speed is the best at 25 kph. View range exactly the same as an HWK-12, and I believe that is it. This covers this vehicle. Yeah, I actually kinda like it, and the main reason why I like it is that ramming capability. Yes, I would like to ram with this vehicle as I do in my E50M. I like to ram stuff in my WZ-132-1, in my E50M, in my E50. I believe this tank is going to be awesome rammer as well, versus other light tanks. Now, please, do not quote me on that. But I have heard rumors that it is not going to be a standard premium vehicle for sale. I have heard that it is going to be a reward vehicle. Maybe for new set of missions, where we have to grind this vehicle out as we did with the D25 Pilot 1. Maybe this could be an option, or maybe other special events where we are able to get, or where we are able to grind this vehicle out. I don't know, but this is what I have heard. Maybe it appears in the shops as well at one point, I don't know, but yeah, this is just what I have heard. And as always, please let me know in the comment section down below what you think about this vehicle after seeing first pictures and after seeing first specs. And that covers it. That covers this topic. Now let's move on into the next topic, which is new HD Fjords. And oh boy, is it beautiful or what, ladies and gents. Keep in mind, graphics at the moment are set to medium. After, you are going to see ultra graphics as well. But the first time I saw this map, I was actually lost at one point. I had to look at the minimap to see where I am. Or when I saw this video. Thank you to Votklu, by the way, for providing us super awesome stuff. Now, minimap is almost exactly the same, but what they did with all the rest of the things, little hills, this church on the top of the hill looks really beautiful as well, all the surroundings, this area, yeah, it is that same old fjords, but it has been tuned a lot. A lot more trees, different covers, so we can say this is kind of a new map, or almost every single new HD map is kind of a new map. Yes, I know the overall layout is almost exactly the same, but it has so much more to give. New hills, new pumps, new rocks, a lot more trees, especially on this map. It is going to change the gameplay. Well, of course it is going to change the gameplay, even adding a couple of bushes, couple of rocks or trees are going to change the gameplay, but let's hope it changes to the better. Yeah, and now for the end of the episode, couple of angles for you with ultra graphics settings on Fjords map as well. Guys, I thank you for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed your weekend. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I catch you next time. Stay awesome, take care, and bye. When I take a breath, you fill up my lungs. And if my mind works backwards just for a minute.